In this video, we'll discuss what entities are, why you would use them, and how to create them. We will use a pet grooming salon to illustrate concepts in this video. For this business, we need information about pet owners, appointments, animals, and so on. In Dynamics 365, these different buckets of information are stored in entities. An entity is a table of information. For example, for the grooming salon, we'll use the built-in contact entity to keep track of pet owners. Each row in the table represents a record in the entity, and each column represents a field in each of those records. In this example, the fields are first name, last name, email, and phone. Dynamics 365 comes with most of the entities you need already built in, including things like appointments, contacts, and invoices. But sometimes you may need to create a custom entity. For the grooming salon example, we'll need to create an entity that contains data about each of the animals, such as name, species, or breed. There are two types of entities in Dynamics 365, activity entities and non-activity entities. An activity is a special kind of entity. Think of an activity as an action you can attach to a record. For the grooming salon, we'll create a non-activity entity named Animal. Let's see how this looks in action. Open the main menu. Click Settings and then Customizations. Next, click Customize the System. Click Entities, then New. In Display Name, enter a singular noun that describes the entity. In Plural Name, enter the plural form of the same noun. The name for this entity will be created automatically based on the display name you've provided. If you want an image or icon for the record in your entity, say the picture of the animal that comes into the salon, create the entity first and then add an image field later. You can come back here afterwards and the image field will be listed in the dropdown so you can add the image. When you create an entity, you have to assign ownership of it to a user or team or to an organization. If a particular person or team will be responsible for maintaining the records, as in this case, or if you are creating an activity entity, set the ownership to user or team. We'll leave define as an activity entity checkbox empty, in this case. Next, provide a description for the entity. Under areas that display this entity, check the appropriate boxes so users can access this information in all the right places. Since the animal entity is directly related to contacts, we'll want this information to be available to sales and service roles. Now select the options you want. If you're not sure whether you want to enable an option, don't select it. You can always select it later. Notice that there are several options with the plus sign next to them. These options cannot be turned off after they have been enabled. Click Save and Close. To make your changes visible to others, click Publish All Customizations. Before other people can see your changes, you'll also need to edit security roles and grant access to the appropriate teams and users. For more information about creating entities and setting up security roles, please search for Creating Entities at this website.